we're going viral. Get ready. We're going viral.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to another installment of the Viral Podcast. I'm your host, Chelcie Lynn.
And I'm your host, Paige Ginn.
Thank you for joining us for another installment of our program.
Thank you.
You are helping us take over the world by being here week after week. We love and appreciate you guys.
Love you so much.
Tonight, guess where I'm going to be? Doing a show in Sacramento, California.
I was going to say in my ass.
Well, in your ass too. And I can do that. I can do that.
God, I love a girl that can do both.
I'll do it. I can do it all. Not only can I do both, I can do it all.
And take over the world.
That's damn. that's not easy to do, but I do it. And then I'll be in Portland, Spokane, Washington, Seattle, and then Eugene, Oregon.
Wow.
And then tour's over.
What?
Yeah.
Already?
Well, for this leg, we're going to take the holidays off, and then I'll be back top of the year.
Okay, so was this a shorter leg?
Shorter stint. I'll be back top of the year working on new material because hopefully I'm going to film something soon.
How long were the other legs?
Like this is the shortest.
6 foot?
We usually do like 3 months. We usually do like 3 months at a time, and we'll take a couple months off. This time we're doing we did a month and a half at a time.
Okay.
So much shorter.
Yeah, I was gonna say that one might really.
Yeah.
Quick. Okay.
So there is that, and we have a guest in the studio. Officer Daniels is here.
Hello.
OD,
thanks for having me.
Yeah, thanks for being here.
And if you don't know who he is, where you been?
Yeah.
Where you been?
What do you mean, where's he been?
Well, no, where have they been if they don't know who Officer Daniels is?
Oh.
Me
okay.
And Daniels have been not only best friends, but doing content together for years.
Almost a decade.
Which is wild.
Crazy.
For real? How'd you meet?
Vine.
Vine, yeah.
Who messaged who?
He claims that I messaged him, but I will tell you this. I have never, not one time, messaged someone famous or a non-famous person or anything to collab with. Not once.
You know it was him.
I can't remember.
He messaged me and said, hey, we should do this video, whatever. And I was like, okay. So
it's got to start somewhere.
Yeah, and it started.
Good
it was
job.
The infamous... I'll beat your ass if that's a ticket.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody loved it.
Yeah.
So we had to just become friends. And here we are.
10 years later.
Crazy.
So we've been wanting to have you on the pod, but we haven't had... The last time you were here, we didn't have the camera set up for the guest. So anyway, you're here now.
I'm here.
And I did want to address something, if y'all don't mind. I have been seeing comments and DMs left and right. Are Officer Daniels and Maggie dating? What's going on with Daniels and Maggie? They're so dating. Oh, I know they're boning, they're dating. If they're not, they need to be. We're here now to address this, and we're going to go deep and give you the answers you're looking for. So, take it away. Daniels, you want to start?
Maggie, you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. I'm into men.
So
that's the answer.
So that's going to be a little hard to be into
so
Maggie.
If that doesn't answer your question. Daniels and Maggie are not dating because
not.
Daniels loves wiener.
He loves wiener.
Cock.
True.
Big gay guy.
Cock
big
and balls.
Gay
big gay guy
yeah.
here.
And we're not even joking. You are gay.
For sure.
And... First time you told me, okay, first off, you've never put, you're out in your personal life.
Mm-hmm.
When you come to shows and you meet, because you come to a lot of shows and women really hit on you.
Yep.
Oh, yeah, you're wanted.
You will tell people, even at shows, like, I'm gay, you've never came out on social media and announced it.
Right.
So this is your first, like, public announcement that you're gay.
Absolutely. Yep, 100% is.
How do you feel?
Yeah, how do you feel?
Oh, great. I've never been one to understand why you have to make an announcement. If it's all, hey, it's not a big deal. If it's not a big deal, then why do I have to tell you I am?
Exactly. You know?
Yeah. And you're pretty private anyway.
True.
I have a feeling that even if you were straight, you would really keep your shit private on online.
Yeah.
So it doesn't matter if you're gay or straight. You're that way anyway.
Yeah. I get what he means though. Like, you don't go and say like, oh, I'm straight. Like, you don't announce that you're straight.
Yeah.
But
some people.
But a lot of women hit on him and also assume that he's in a relationship with one of us or with Beth sometimes, with Maggie for the past couple months. So
all
it's like,
the time.
Yeah, that's not it.
All the time.
Yeah.
It's the penis.
I feel like we just hang out.
Yeah, we just hang out.
Yeah.
You feel like
so
what?
So like the ladies that hit on me at your shows, I get really uncomfortable, not because they're hitting on me. I don't want them to feel bad. Like, I'm like, it has nothing to do with you. I'm not into women.
You like cock and balls.
Right.
Yeah.
No, but I don't want them to feel like they're not pretty or, you know.
Like you're just turning away from them because you don't. Makes sense. That, well, that's nice because anybody getting ghosted, it sucks being ghosted.
Yeah, Maggie.
Maggie, no.
No, first time you told me that you were gay, I didn't believe you. And I don't know why. I thought you were fucking, I was like, why are you saying, like, you know, I was like, what are you talking about? So one of the first, I think it's the first time I ever met you and we hung out. We had been online friends for a while.
Yep.
We were in Los Angeles. We went to VidCon. I drove, first and only time I'll ever go to that shit. I hated it, but anyway, I drove up from San Diego. I think you invited me. We went to VidCon. There was a party after. We went to the party. And then you were staying in a hotel, and it was pretty late. And I was like, man, oh, got to drive back home. And you were like, oh, I have an extra bed in my hotel room. And I remember thinking, oh, no, that's okay. I'll just drive home. And I thought, he's trying to fuck me. He's going to get me in that hotel room and try to put his fingers in my pussy.
Oh, yeah. He would, too.
Yeah, I really thought that. I go, okay. I'm not spending the night with some guy in a hotel room.
Well, usually men don't just really.
And now he's all
that,
sleeping
you know?
In your bed.
Yeah, well, you know.
I just wanted to be your gay best friend.
I know, and I didn't know that at the time.
You don't know that if you don't know you're gay.
And if I would have known that then, if I would have known you were gay, I would have. I'd been like, okay, you got an extra bed? Let's do it.
Yeah.
But I didn't know you were gay, so you told me after, and I was like, oh, okay.
You should have started it out with that. And then ask for the sleepover.
Yeah.
Because, you know, usually straight dudes don't say, come sleep in my bed, mama.
Right, unless they...
Unless they're going to stick it in the holes.
Holes. Plural.
Yeah, so do you stick it in the holes or what is it?
Oh, yeah, your top or bottom? And we don't have to spend a long time on this. Hey, I'm just asking questions I know people are going to want to know.
The end goal, they will want to know.
So go ahead. Go ahead.
Not a bottom here.
Okay.
Not a big bottom guy here.
Okay.
So you stick it in the hole.
Yeah, I don't want to get into details, but I had a traumatic experience a long time ago giving it. And
Mal-icky.
You're not into holes either.
Not really.
Okay. You just love wiener.
Yeah.
The wiener part.
Do you like sucking?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Would you rather get sucked or suck?
Probably suck. I don't know.
Suck.
Wow, he's like you.
I love sucking dick. Mm-hmm.
And you two are a lot alike. You actually look alike.
Well, and we look like brother and sister.
I think
you
we're related.
You do look like twins.
It's weird.
People always say you guys look like twins.
And we're very much like brother and sister. Like, you get on my nerves a lot, mm-hmm. and like, I'll tell you.
Mm-hmm.
Or I'll be like, stop! Stop saying that! Or something. You know, we're very brother-sister relationship.
Have I stopped scaring you, though?
You have.
Not me.
And thank you for that.
But you haven't flipped out on me yet.
I flipped out on his ass.
That's what it takes.
That's what it takes.
Because damn, dude, he's hiding behind every wall. I've even said it on here before, like, Daniel's just hiding in my... Mm-hmm. Oh, God, I hate it.
Yep.
In the dark. And you just scream so loud.
Yeah.
You also stopped doing something else that used to get on my nerves bad.
I already know what it is.
Well, you haven't stopped completely, but you've calmed down a
lot.
Let's
see if he knows what it is.
What?
Can you give me a hint?
I know what it is.
No.
Don't give him a hint?
Well.
Oh.
Okay.
It's when you're out in public.
Oh. Yeah.
What?
Making an announcement.
Yeah. Thank you. We'll be somewhere. Restaurant. Don't matter. Our waiter walk up. He'll point at me and he goes, do you know who that is? You ever seen her? You ever seen her videos on TikTok, Facebook?
We bring on a guest to tell him every roast.
Start roasting his ass. And I would be like, stop fucking doing that. Oh. You don't really do that much anymore.
Well, that's because you had to go postal on me, too.
Yeah.
Do you remember that? Do you remember that time?
Uh-uh.
Here's the thing.
When I ask you to stop doing something, you don't listen and you keep doing it. So it boils and boils and boils to the point where I lose my shit. Yeah. And I'm like, I said fucking stop doing that.
Yeah, well, don't get her to that boiling point.
I remember the boiling point.
I don't remember what happened. What happened?
When we were, well, first I was all pissed off because we went to the wrong karaoke place. You remember this now in San Diego?
Oh my gosh, yeah.
We were supposed to go to a karaoke bar. And Brett took us to some old folks karaoke bar with a small little screen.
That was fun. Go ahead.
And so then I was all pouty because I'm like, this is lame. And you
stop being.
So then we went to the other one.
And what?
And I was the last person to get picked for karaoke for the night. And I announced it to the whole bar. Chelcie, Trailer Trash Tammy's here. Get her up on stage to sing with me. You were so mad. You didn't talk to me in the car.
She turned to me and said, I'm so pissed at Officer Daniels. And she's like, he knows that I hate this. And you're up there on stage going, Trailer Trash Tammy's here tonight. And like, just
get her up on stage.
Yeah, and I saw you look down at Chelcie just like, she was pissed.
I was mad at her. She was mad at me at that point. I'm like, I'm just going to go for it.
That was my first time realizing how close you two were. Just like the brother-sister thing.
Yes, very brother-sister. So, no, me and Daniels are not fucking. I get that a lot, too. Daniels is not fucking anybody here.
No, his cock's safe around here.
Yeah, it's really safe around here.
Stays locked up.
Yeah, that thing stays locked up. Him and Maggie are not dating, so.
Could you imagine them two dating?
That'd be weird. That'd be really weird.
I think we'd make a cute couple, though.
Really?
If I was.
Yeah.
Maggie, would you date Daniels?
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's weird to say because you can't really gauge.
You don't know because I've never even thought about that.
Yeah.
But that's maybe. He's a very good looking man.
Yeah. Did you just say?
Yeah.
Did Brett just say oral for an hour?
Yeah. Can you do that?
Oh, yeah, the guy she's fucking gives her oral for an hour.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. His name should be Oral.
If you can't stand it. Yeah, if you can't top that, I'm not fucking with you.
Yeah.
If you can't, can you hold your breath for one hour?
Dang.
Right. Wow. Damn. Are you one of those gold star gays?
I don't know what that means.
Like you've never been with a woman?
Oh, no. 3 times.
Oh, that's right. I knew that, too. I don't know why I asked that. I did know that.
3 times.
Yeah, I went through a phase where I tried to force myself.
Yeah.
And it was just like too wet,
too stinky.
What was it?
Wasn't pleasurable. Like,
well, we're glad you don't have to force yourself anymore, and that you can be yourself and gay. We love gays,
and we
love you.
Oh, just anybody. Hey, when did you know that you had a hankering for dick?
Good question.
My whole life.
Just since
elementary school.
What was like the first thing though? Like, just whatever you saw your.
Jonathan Taylor Thomas.
Like I saw my freaking. Who's that?
Right. You're like
Home Improvement.
Yeah, Home Improvement. Tool Time.
The kid. Tool Time.
Oh, I wanted him so bad. Isn't it weird how when we were kids we wanted to fuck?
And what's he doing now?
Don't know. But go ahead.
I can't recall like the aha moment, but I do know in elementary school I was thinking that.
Thinking boys or thinking.
Okay.
And I think it was kind of, I mean, some people pick up on it immediately. Like they just know. I got asked in middle school and high school and adamantly denied it. Right.
Asked if you were gay?
Mm-hmm.
By who?
Just classmates.
Okay. Okay.
That's cool. They would just come up and ask.
Or rude. I don't know. Why'd they ask?
I have no idea. I think. Okay. Had a little flamboyant tendency or something.
Oh, they just knew. They had the gaydar on.
Okay. Well, damn, I didn't even know.
Mm-mm. Hey.
And I feel like I have good gaydar.
I would have never known. But it's like, then you get the people that say, oh, well, you don't stereotype.
Sure. Gay,
but it's like.
Sure.
Come on.
Yeah. Yeah.
He just doesn't come off as a gay man
right.
to me. Like I.
But you know how I really knew he was gay?
When he
ate my ass. No. No, truthfully.
What?
When you after you told me you were gay, I was kind of like, ah. I asked you a question, and you gave me an answer, and I thought, damn, he gay.
What was it?
I said, this is when we first started. It was after that. I go, who's like your number one like musical art, like your favorite band or musical artist? And this motherfucker, without skipping a beat, says Kelly Clarkson. And I go, he gay.
Dude, that. Yeah,
Kelly Clarkson? And I go, wow. I don't know how I didn't spot that a mile away, man.
And he carries a steamer.
He carries a steamer.
Oh, yeah.
Now travel with a steamer.
Yeah, you
now
do.
That we know, you definitely,
yeah,
you know.
Have some tendencies, for sure.
Well, yeah, now that I know how. And sometimes you're just a little dramatic. If we want to add some stuff to the roast. All right.
Love
is
roasting
the, is
you.
The roast cooked or are
hey,
we
hey,
about done?
The roast is done. You guys ready to eat my ass?
Yeah.
Anything Dude. Else you want to throw in?
Yeah.
Hello and welcome to the Moo Moo commercials. Listen, honeys, if you're a longtime listener, okay, if you are an OG rock, all right, you might know that, hey, we've been rocking AG1 for about a year now. We love it. We will always be talking about AG1 as long as we're chugging it, baby. Malt leaky, baby. Listen, I get up, okay? I don't have to worry about a bunch of pills. I don't have to worry about, oh, opening this bottle and taking out two pills here and opening that bottle and taking out four pills there. I'm not doing that no more, okay? I'm using one hand motion, and that's to scoop one little scoop, and that's all I'm doing. Listen, my wrist is sore already. I'm not doing a bunch of twists on bottles anymore. I'm done with it. I'm tired of it, okay? Using AG1, one scoop, baby. I just feel better, man. A little less stressed, more focused. That's because AG1 is a foundational nutrition system that supports your body's universal needs like gut optimization, stress management, and immune support. Since 2010, AG1 has led the future of foundational nutrition, continuously refining their formula to create a smarter, better way to elevate your baseline health. Not only did I replace all my vitamins with AG1, but I love that every scoop also includes prebiotics, probiotics, and enzymes for gut support. Listen, them shrimps be singing, baby. You guys know that, okay? Them shrimps can be singing, and they will sing a whole choir if I'm not scooping out this stuff daily. And it's easy, okay? That's the main thing for me. It is so easy. You got it all right there. You're not worried about a million things. You just scoop it and go, and you're done with it. You're done with it for the day. Hey, honeys, did my healthy thing for the day. AG1 is a supplement I trust to provide the support my body needs daily, and that's why we've been partnering with them for so long, you guys. If you want to take ownership over your health, it starts with AG1. Try AG1 and get a free one-year supply of vitamin D3K2, and 5 free AG1 travel packs with your first purchase. Go to drinkag1.com/viral. That's drinkag1.com/viral. Check it out.
Potatoes.
I don't
carrots.
Think so.
You good?
Anything like does everyone know in your family? Can we ask that?
The answer is no, but I don't.
Yeah,
I don't think they'll ever.
I think most everybody knows, though.
Yeah, pretty much. I'm very open in my private life for sure. Yeah.
But no family member has ever came up and asked you before you.
No, so when it came time to like finally do that,
mm-hmm.
like one of my sisters, I went to first because I knew.
She knew.
No, she didn't.
Oh,
I just
she didn't.
I knew that she'd be okay with it.
Wow.
And so I'm like, hey, so has the family, like, talked about this? Like, is there speculation? She's like, mm-mm. I'm like, gosh, dang it. I wanted it to
yeah,
be.
Yeah, of course.
Just to make it so much easier.
Yeah.
So I'm like, gosh, now I don't know how anybody's going to respond.
Mm-hmm.
Where I was just hoping, like, hey, yeah, they were just waiting for you to say something.
Right, right, right.
So.
And you were a little scared because your parents are religious. Mm-hmm. So yeah. I get that, like, you know.
And
you
also know. Some family members aren't so open to that. Like, my right. family members would, of course, be like, oh, he's gay, you know? Yeah. Like,
we you
would,
gay?
Yeah. You gay? Or we would be talking about it like, oh, you know, I think Jerry's gay, you yeah. know? So maybe your family isn't, are as they like that, you know, as open?
I was surprised. Yeah. I didn't know what to expect, but I will say I'm very fortunate. I've never lost a friend or a family member because of it. So,
good.
Well, you shouldn't.
Right.
Shouldn't, but
yeah.
I know that's not the case for everybody.
Right, yeah. Right, right. Well, yeah. We love you. We're glad you're gay, and mm-hmm. we're glad you're here on our podcast.
When you were saying he's here, I'm like, I'm here. I wanted to say I'm queer.
I know.
I wanted to so bad. I'm like, I can't talk about it yet.
Me and Daniels looked at each other like, say I'm here and I'm queer. But
do you want to roast me about anything before we move on?
Do it.
No.
Do it.
Am I perfect?
You are perfect.
Can I ask
I got a,
question? A
couple things.
Brett.
Oh, hey, sorry. Brett.
I just want to know, so the here? three girls you were with, did yes. you bust a nut?
Nope.
That's a good question.
Ooh.
Yeah. You tried. Did it get hard?
Mm-hmm.
Brett, why'd you make a fist when you said, did it get hard?
Don't make a fist, oh. Brett. God.
Wow, that was weird.
That was weird.
So,
Maggie, do you have any questions?
I don't think so.
We talk to him every day.
I know.
I don't think so.
Okay.
Well,
yeah, you guys know most of these answers anyway.
I know. But I'm asking what right. I know people are going
right, to. It's nice having sure. a gay friend, because now all those people that, you know, said, oh, Paige and Chelcie hate gay people.
Huh?
Yeah.
Somebody said that?
We've had some of those.
Fuck you.
So, but you know how now we have a friend. And we're good. We're
we
covered.
We have so many gay friends, too.
We're good.
State your name.
And yeah. you know what? Me and you did an ice cream video several years ago where we're making out.
People are so mad.
And he got so much hate for it.
You're making out with a married woman. What's your husband think?
Oh, I'm God. Like,
he got so much shit for
her husband filmed the damn video. What do you want from me?
Yeah. And it's like, don't even get me into that. But yeah, you got a lot of hate for that. And
can't just act anymore.
No. They don't say that to people like in movies.
Yeah.
I know, just because of the camera is a little nicer.
Greg literally filmed it. You think he gives a fuck?
Get a nice camera, and then you guys can do that.
Right.
And the funny thing is, even if I wasn't gay, that still would have happened. That video would have
yeah,
happened.
It absolutely.
Has nothing to do with anything between you and me.
Nope. Yeah. You're right. If you were straight, we still would have done that video.
Yep.
You're right.
Well, what if it wasn't even about the gay or Daniels being gay or straight, about you being married?
That's hey, and hey, acting is acting. Can you imagine me being like, hey, babe, gonna film some stuff, sucking this guy's cock. Greg be like, okay, you want me to film it for you, babe?
Yeah.
I've got a have you heard. We haven't done a have you heard, and I think we should get into it. Daniels, it's a little segment where
have you heard what?
Well, let me tell you. Have you heard?
Sorry, hold on.
It's all right. Maggie's getting a little soundbite.
Have you heard what?
Have you heard you're going to eat my ass?
What?
You're going to eat my ass?
Have you heard?
Daniels, do you love eating ass?
Did you?
Mm-hmm.
You love eating ass.
Mm-hmm. Clean
when you,
ass.
Well, obviously. Uh-oh. When you eat ass, do you finger it? Or just
not
eat
usually.
It? Okay.
Wait, do you get your butthole waxed?
No, I never have. The only thing I've ever had waxed is my eyebrows.
We should go have your butthole waxed. We should go do that.
It doesn't hurt.
No.
What?
Brett?
Maggie said it doesn't hurt.
No, the butthole doesn't.
Oh,
the,
yeah, just
the butthole.
Oh, the butthole doesn't hurt.
The butthole.
Specifically.
All right. Have y'all heard? A 104-year-old woman dies before Guinness can confirm her record as the oldest skydiver. A 104-year-old woman has died a little more than a week after she potentially broke the world record for the oldest skydiver. Dorothy Hoffner jumped 13,000 feet from a plane with Skydive Chicago in Ottawa on October 1st. She likely died in her sleep Monday at Brookdale Senior Living. The center said, the associates at Brookdale Lakeview are deeply saddened by the passing of our resident, Dorothy Hoffner. The statement said, we were thrilled to see her continue to live with passion and purpose, skydiving earlier this month at 104, and ultimately proving that age is just a number. She'll be greatly missed by our entire community. Guinness World Records is still working to confirm if Hoffner broke the record for the oldest person to jump from a plane. The current record belongs to Linnea Ignard of Sweden, who was 103 when she made the jump in 2022. Wow. Okay. She wasn't giving up on life. 104, man. She's doing things she's never done before, and I love that.
Damn, I can barely get off the couch.
At 32.
I'm hurting.
Yeah. Or however old you are. Okay. How old are you?
34.
Okay, that's right. Okay. A python caught after 4 months on the loose in Oklahoma. An 8-foot python on the loose in an Oklahoma City trailer park for 4 months was safely captured by reptile rescuers. Snakes Alive Exotics Rescue and Sanctuary said the snake was located Wednesday in the Burntwood area, where it had been on the loose and sporadically sighted since June. Local residents had voiced suspicions about the python living off neighborhood cats. But rescuers say the python showed no signs of having been recently fed on pets or wild animals. The snake, an albino golden child python, was malnourished and suffering from a respiratory infection. The python will be taken to a rehab facility, rescuers said. Who are these reptile rescuers? Are they just some dude from the trailer park wanting to catch a snake?
Sure.
I don't know, but that takes a different type of person.
Oh, absolutely. And can you imagine seeing an eight foot white albino snake? Oh, God, I would just...
Ugh. And wanting to just wrangle it and put it in a cage?
Listen to this one. Dead body turns out to be just a very dirty, broken, and overused sex doll. Reports of a dead body dumped in the English woods were blown out of proportion. It turned out to be a very dirty, broken, and overused sex doll, according to the cops. Cops closed off a road for 31 hours as part of efforts to seal the kinky crime scene in the West Midlands village of Keenton after someone taking a stroll called authorities to say they had seen limbs sticking out from the underground. The police thought they had a murder investigation on their hands, so they called in a forensics team, a local source told The Sun. But upon closer inspection, which no doubt included old-fashioned detective work, authorities determined the find was more goofy than grisly, the report said.
And gooey, probably.
Ooh. It is with great relief that we can announce that the pathologist was able to identify that the foot and hand beneath the bush did in fact belong to a discarded and realistic life-size doll, police said. The officers had a big laugh about it. It was a very dirty, broken, and overused sex doll.
I bet they could test out its cum and go take it back to its owner.
Dude, and the fact that it was dirty and overused.
Like broken in. Dang, they went to town with that one.
They went to town.
And I bet that was expensive. Why are you just dumping it in the...
If it was realistic, it's not one of those blow-up dolls. No. This doll was
expensive.
Like,
yeah, this is a...
Aren't those like thousands?
Mm-hmm. Exactly. I used to put one of the blow-up ones in my seat for carpool.
Dude, that thing was just full of cum, dude.
Oh, just floating?
Just floating cum.
Buyer's remorse. Whoa, sorry.
Huh?
Whoa.
Dang, that was loud.
Too close.
Buyer's remorse.
Brett, what do you mean buyer's remorse?
Yeah, what's that?
You know, you get something and then you just... Wait, that's when you take it back, huh?
Yeah, you don't throw it in the lake.
Yeah, Brett leaned back.
Sorry about that.
If you got sex doll money to throw in a lake, you have money.
Right.
Well, that's something you don't think about when you buy something like that, when you're ready to get rid of it. What do you do with that?
Throw it in a lake.
You're right. What do you do with that?
You can't drop it off at the Goodwill.
Did I tell y'all, I mentioned this on the pod a long time ago. I watched a sex doll porn and it was hot.
Oh, you said that. Mm-hmm.
And... I would never type that in, but I was scrolling, and I saw it, and I was like, let me check this out. I don't know why. It was so fucking hot. This guy was just fucking a doll.
Oh, dude, Bonnie.
And I...
Dang.
Fuck you!
You used to fuck a doll. Maybe that's your kink, and we just found it.
I used to... You know this, Daniels. I had a doll named Bonnie, and she was soft like a pillow.
Soft. And no, don't say soft like a pillow, well, and then say what you're gonna say.
But she wasn't like a hard plastic doll. She was a pillow,
in like the stuff
in the shape of a doll, and it had a little face on it, but it was a pillow. And I would hump that thing every night, dude, and bust nuts on Bonnie. I say, ever since I have came out and said that on this podcast, I have never received so many messages. Women who come to my shows and say, oh my God, I've never heard another woman admit they fucked their dolls. I did too.
Damn.
And I was fucking my dolls. I will admit that.
Doll fucker.
And full nutting. So maybe, yeah, maybe that somehow ties together. I don't know. I never thought about that. But
yeah, that and Dolly.
And I, like Dolly. And I love Dolly Parton, so you're
man,
right.
Man, all those kids out there busting nuts.
Oh,
on their kids. Yeah, it makes me toys? Never want to touch God. Their toys. Like, get that fucking doll away from me.
God. Next time a kid wants me to play with their doll, I'm going to fucking throw it. Like, hell no. I know what you're doing. I was once there.
Yeah, and the boys are probably shoving their little cars up their ass.
Oh, gosh.
Get toys away from people.
So many... Anyway, yeah, I watched a little sex doll porn.
You remember Real Sex on HBO?
Uh-uh. Mm-hmm. Oh, no. Brett, yeah, you do?
That's kind of older.
Okay.
Like HBO.
You say yeah, it was probably my teens. It would play on HBO like late at night.
Tip. You used to come to it?
Well, no, but it was all full nude and these stories about sexual things. And there was an episode about those real life dolls.
Like,
and they were like $15,000 back then.
Whoa, so that crazy. With inflation, they got to be up in the hundreds of thousands.
I imagine technology's probably made them less, kind of like a TV, but...
Yeah, kicking them out quicker.
Mm-hmm.
Remember when computers were, like, so fucking
20,000, 30,000.
Expensive, and then they got real cheap. You can get a computer for, like, $300, and now they're back up.
A gateway.
Now they're back up to $2,000
more
a laptop.
More expensive.
Yeah.
Dude, life's just crazy. And why?
Well, life is crazy, if you think about it.
And I just feel like we're being held back by technology. I mean, come on. You can't even search for the album in your photos.
Oh, yeah. You've been talking about that.
It's really pissing me off.
Go ahead.
You will know, because Daniel's also, we should talk about how technical he is, but in your photos, you can't search for an album. You can name your albums in an iPhone, but you can't search for the album name.
Gotcha. I've never used photos that way. I just... scroll.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
Or I favorite the ones that I know I'm going to want to go back for.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I've just been trying to put them in albums, so just easier.
Easier. Smart.
But it's not, because fair. Apple.
Yeah.
But they could do that, because come on.
They can do anything.
Yeah.
I just don't think anybody's thought about it yet.
Okay. Well, I guess we just told them.
Yeah, we just told them. You know they're listening.
Oh.
Tweet.
They are listening.
What do you call it now? You don't tweet now. What do you do?
X.
You X people? X Apple and say, hey.
Mm. Nobody's ever going to say X.
Dude, right. people need to stop saying X, formerly known as Twitter. You know?
Just say kinda. Twitter. I know it's not called Twitter, but don't say, oh, send out an X. Don't do that.
Just send out a tweet.
And don't say, oh, get on Twitter and go, it's not called Twitter no more. It's called X. Don't say that either. Did you say that?
No.
Oh.
Oh.
Did I?
Don't say that. So. Let's continue to call it Twitter, because that's what it is.
It throws me off. I still can't find it. I'm looking for that blue bird.
I know. And I literally sometimes will see the X app, and I will go, what's that?
For real.
And then I remember. Yeah.
It's weird. You got to just adjust. Your brain's got to slowly adjust to new things on your phone, but we all do it. You know, we just glide with the new.
Amen.
Amen.
Should we jump on a call, or what do you want to do, Paige?
What do you want to do, Daniels? Do you want to finish some lyrics, or do you want to jump on a call?
Ooh.
Do I get to play?
Yeah.
Finish the lyrics? I'd love to play finish the lyrics.
Okay.
Okay. Well, I guess we could just do ours to him.
Let's do it. I have a feeling that you're going to get every single one of these.
Really?
Yeah.
Ooh.
I feel like you're really good at lyrics.
Then maybe we should do our lyrics and then have Maggie, Brett, have all three of them do it.
Okay. Or Daniels, he's a special guest.
Oh, yeah.
Mom
okay.
always said finish
if
your
he
plane.
Doesn't get it, though.
My ex always said finish on the first date. But I always say
finish the lyrics.
Okay.
That was beautiful.
So I will sing.
Okay.
And then when I stop, you got to get it word for word.
Okay.
And okay, you ready?
Yep.
You should be able to get this one. 3:30 in the morning, not a soul in sight. The city's looking like it goes down on a moonless summer night. Raindrops on the windshield, there's a storm moving in.
Oh, shoot.
What the fuck?
I could sing it with you, but as soon as you stopped, 3:30 in the morning, not a soul in sight. City's looking like a ghost town in a moonlit summer night.
Raindrops on the windshield. There's a storm moving in. Where's he heading?
I'm heading back to somewhere where I never should have been. And the thunder rolls.
Okay.
Man, that's a little more
and the thunder rolls.
Scary.
You got a little backwards, but you got it.
Okay. I'll help you out if I can, but okay. I probably will barely be there.
Okay.
You know.
Would you have gotten that?
No.
Okay.
I think it was the fact that Cher was singing it, not Garth.
Oh, raindrops on the windshield, there's a storm moving in.
That's John Anderson. All
right, ready? Next one.
Okay.
I'm going out tonight, I'm feeling all right, gonna let it all hang out, wanna make some noise, really raise my voice, yeah, I wanna scream and shout, No inhibitions, make no conditions, get a little out of line. I only wanna, I messed up, have a good time.
The best thing about being a woman is our prerogative is to have a little fun.
Woo!
Why don't they say prerogative?
I thought it was prerogative.
It is prerogative.
Okay.
Yeah.
I messed up a little bit there.
She just says it weird. Yeah. I had to Google that.
She does say it weird.
Chelcie.
Yes, honeys.
Nothing.
What? Say it.
That I was looking up, isn't that Shania Twain?
Yeah.
I was fucking looking. Why do we do the same song when there's...
Did you do the same song?
That's what I have, but I have a bunch written down, but I'm like, what the fuck, dude? Why? Does it, like, send them to both of us when look it up? I'm confused as fuck.
Yeah. Okay.
Have one more?
No, that's it. We supposed to have three. Sorry about that.
Oh, well, perfect then. I'll just do this one.
I'll look up another one. Go ahead.
Okay.
All right, here she goes.
Okay. When the sun shines, we'll shine together. Told you I'll be here forever. Said I'll always be a friend. Took an oath, I'ma stick it out till the end. Now that it's raining more than ever.
Yeah, we still have each other.
Come on.
Someone stick it out till the end?
No, bitch. No.
That was already.
You can stand under my umbrella.
Oh.
Ella.
It just went into the okay.
Hey, good job.
Did I get
though.
That first part right?
Yeah, you actually you said now that we'll still have each other. Brother? You okay. did say that, but then you didn't get the.
I couldn't remember. I thought there was more before the chorus.
Oh yeah.
Or the main line.
Oh, another little line.
Mm-hmm.
No. Okay. Ready?
Ready.
Just kidding.
Here we go.
I want your drama, the touch of your hand. I want your leather-studded kiss in the sand. I want your love. Love, 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 I want your love. You know that I want you. And you know that I need you. I want your bad romance.
I don't know.
I want your love and I don't want your revenge. You and me could write a bad romance.
Okay. I don't know that song. Okay. I mean, I know it, but I don't.
Well, we should have put a
Kelly Clarkson. Well, you would have
known it. We should have put a Kelly Clarkson.
I know
you think I know Lady Gaga.
I should have put a Kelly Clarkson. I didn't know you were going to.
Yeah. You got another one?
Yeah.
Because I got one. Go ahead.
Okay.
All right, here we go.
Don't you ever say I just walked away. I will always want you. I can't live a lie, running for my life. I will always want you.
I came in like a rat. Oh, isn't
Jesus Christ busted my fucking eardrums?
It was going.
I thought that's what you guys want.
See, dramatic. Damn!
Don't we have a live editor?
We don't know what we're doing
here. I didn't
here.
Know you were going to scream.
I'll be shocked if this even records. I pray every episode that it records. Okay. All right. Let's just give you that one, okay?
I'm hot. Is that not, was that right, though?
Sure.
Okay. Yeah.
All right. I got one for you.
My glasses are fogging up. Oh,
keeping
shoot.
On with the night.
You were so mad.
Oh, man. All right. Keeping up with the 90s country trend. You ready?
I'm ready.
Every time our eyes meet, this feeling inside me is almost more than I can take. Baby, when you touch me, I can feel how much you love me, and it just blows me away.
Lord, it feels like the first time.
Nope.
Oh, damn.
I've never been
this close to anyone or anything.
Keep going. I can hear your thoughts.
I can see your dreams.
Okay. You are such a 90s. He didn't get that.
I don't know what I'll do with my love. I'm so in love with you.
I love sucking your cock.
Then when you shove it in my ass.
Keep going.
Then you rub my cheeks or put it in your pussy.
Oh, that was beautiful.
What song is that?
Amazed by Lone Star. Oh,
yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I kind of...
Every time our eyes meet, I want your penis inside me. I want you to blow me away.
Mm. Yeah, blow me away.
We love doing that.
Oh, we love doing that. That needs to be a segment. My songs that we rearrange.
Yes, my dad's favorite one was the Gautier.
Oh, yeah.
But
you didn't have to suck me off.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Wait, I got something for you. What? So it's not a finish the lyrics, but it's a question about a song.
Oh, shit.
What you got?
How much time or how much money did Tim McGraw spend at the county fair?
$48.
Nice. Good job.
What the hell?
If you just said what the hell, you gotta eat my ass.
What the hell?
Wow, so you wanna do it?
Twice.
Spent $48 last night at the county fair. She spread open her legs.
She let me lick her hair.
Oh!
Yeah, she's got a hairy pussy, yeah. Who sings that, Tim McGraw?
Yeah.
Dude, we met that dude.
And I'm telling you right now, if I was a singer, oh, God, I wouldn't even do the original lyrics to my songs. I would literally go up there and talk about...
That's what I want to fucking do.
Yeah. You do want to do that.
I have said that for so long. I just want to, that's what I would do, I think, first.
You want to start a band.
Well, that too. I think me, you, and Libby need to start a band, but just standing or switching lyrics like Bo Burnham and shit.
Yeah.
Funny.
Oh, I love Bo.
Yeah.
Gotta love Bo.
Yeah.
He's great.
He's like one of the first content creators on YouTube that I ever followed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Would you eat his ass? No.
Would you eat his ass?
No.
Okay.
I don't think so.
Well, I think you're lying, but okay.
I don't even know what he looks like today.
Oh.
Well, would you have done that back in the day?
An ass is an ass. he ain't licking his face.
You're not getting a new one either.
Yeah.
I don't think so. Okay. Not my type.
Okay. Well.
Would you?
Yeah.
Really?
If he wanted me to, and I was fucking him. You know?
Yeah.
Maybe. I'm not going to go trying to make this happen or anything.
Oh, no.
You know,
I didn't think it was going to.
I'm not going to seek after this to happen.
Oh, no.
But
didn't even imagine
if
it.
Stars aligned and we were doing it and he bent over, I'd be like, okay, he wants me to munch on it.
The opportunity presented itself.
Yeah, I probably would.
If it arises.
I don't want to, but sometimes you got to do things in life you don't want to do.
Yeah, we got anal beads last week, and nobody knew because it was so discreet.
Yeah, we got anal beads last week. Ooh, baby, it was so discreet.
Do you like busting nuts? I know you do.
The best way to get started is to go to adamandeve.com.
Okay. And you guys know we've been working with adamandeve.com on this podcast for a while, and there's a reason why. Okay. They know what they're talking about when it comes to busting a nut. They have been in business for decades. Want a better rubbing one out on a Tuesday night by yourself life? You got a partner you want to amp it up with? You got multiple partners all at once? Hell, we don't care what you got going on. We just want you having fun. And Adam and Eve's going to have everything you need to do that. We're talking dildos, vibrators, butt plugs,
clit suckers, anal beads, cock rings, lube, lingerie, and much, much more.
And it's discreet shipping. So what are you waiting for? Stop waiting around. Get clicking today.
Adam and Eve is offering 50% off almost any one item and free shipping.
Just enter code VIRAL at checkout. That's VIRAL, V-I-R-A-L, at adamandeve.com. This is exclusive offer specific to this podcast, so be sure to use this code VIRAL to get your discount. 100% free shipping, and get it fast with rush processing. Code VIRAL. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, well, we have some more stuff planned, but can we do something we haven't done in a while? And please, 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 this is going to be amazing. Why don't you go ahead and hand me that book behind you?
Letters to Penthouse by Chelcie.
It's been a minute since we've done this.
I'm happy.
It's been a while.
50% of people love this and want me to do it every episode. And 50% of people skip through this part. Please do not skip through this part because this is a good one.
What don't they like about it?
Don't know.
Huh.
Don't know. So, Daniels, you have just basically I'm going to read, and you just sit and enjoy.
I'm going to enjoy it.
Shut your eyes.
Close your eyes.
Okay.
Try to pop a boner.
Try to pop a boner. Everybody just relax.
I'm hard.
Getting your horny. What?
I wish our lights had a dimmer and like.
That's okay. Get in your horny mode. Is everyone ready? Letters to Penthouse by Chelcie. Titled. She said he was sick, but then she caught the sex fever herself. After 20 years of being married to Ginny, I thought I knew her well. But last August, our lives changed forever in one night. My 44-year-old wife is a slightly average-looking woman, and our sex life was average as well. Everybody okay over there? What was that? Brett just popped a boner. Okay. All right, ready? My only other outlet was reading Penthouse letters every month. Then a couple of years ago, she found my stash of magazines. And during the argument, I blurted out that I'd always fantasized about her doing it with another man. Fucking and sucking like the slut I wished she was while I watched. You think about me doing that? She said in amazement. And it turned you on? I admitted that it did. And she looked like she didn't know whether to hit me or to laugh herself silly. You know I would never do anything like that, she said. God, you're really sick. After that, I kept on buying the magazines, but I no longer hid them. Ginny didn't say anything more about it, and our lives went on. On Ginny's birthday last August, we decided to celebrate by leaving the kids with their grandparents and going into the city, where we would have a nice dinner and get a hotel room for the night. Ginny got dolled up and looked great. I told her how sexy she looked, but she said she thought her ass was too big. But I like a nice, round ass. We had dinner in the hotel dining room, then got a booth in the lounge and had a few drinks. We watched the place fill up while getting a little buzz going. Ginny rarely drinks, and she was slightly unsteady on her feet when she went off to the ladies' room. As she made her way back to our booth, she was momentarily stopped by a group of people, and a big black dude bumped into her from behind. He leaned over and said something to her, causing her to turn and laugh. They struck up a conversation, laughing, and it seemed to me flirting with each other. After 4 or 5 minutes, Ginny turned to me and waved. I waved back, and the black dude nodded to me. Ginny returned to the booth, and I couldn't help noticing her meaty nipples poking against...
Meaty nipples! What the fuck is a meaty nipple?
Poking against the material of her sexy blue dress. What was that all about? I asked as she slid into the booth. His name's Jim, Ginny told me. He's a state trooper. He's really nice and funny and... She giggled. He's got a really big cock.
He's got...
How do you know that? I asked. I felt it when he bumped into me. And then he pressed it against me. It's huge, and I want it. I told him you wanted to watch, and he said sure, as long as I fucked his friend, too. So you can watch both men fuck me. Before I could recover from my astonishment at this amazing turn of events, two beefy black guys came up to our booth. Ginny introduced them as Jim and Ed, and soon they were seated in the booth with Ginny between them. Jim began the conversation. Your wife says that you want to watch her fuck, is that right?
Jesus.
Me at dinner. As he spoke, Ed reached over and boldly tweaked my wife's right nipple. I was transfixed at the sight. And Jim continued, married women love black cock, but I've never had one in front of her husband before. Ed's hand went below the table, and Ginny's eyes locked on mine as she deliberately shifted to allow him to access her pussy. Your wife's cunt is soaked, Ed said.
Soaked.
Can you imagine coming up and being like, you guys want some refills? She's ready for some black cock, all right.
Damn. Oh, God.
Jim's hand went to check it out, and he grinned at me. This woman is dripping, man. Oh. She wants what we've got. Take your panties off, honey, so your hubby can see for himself. With a bit of effort, Ginny wiggled out of her panties and gave them to me. The crotch was soaking. And the tangy aroma.
Holy shit.
And the tangy. And the tangy aroma of her pussy wafted through the booth as my wife spread her legs so two strangers could fill her up. After a minute, she started to gasp, and Jim told me, I've got a finger in your wife's pussy. Can you imagine? Be like, all right, anything else I can use? You ready for the check?
What about being in the booth behind them and you smell pussy?
Okay.
Ready? And you're eavesdropping? Because I'd be doing that.
A big finger, honey, Ginny said. Then she gasped again. Oh, two big fingers. Oh, God, play with my pussy. Rub it hard. Her hands were under the table now, grasping their dicks through their pants. She's ready. Let's go to your room, Jim said. We got up, and the four of us made our way to the room. with me following the others like a little puppy dog. As soon as the door closed, Jim and Ed were all over my wife, kissing her, feeling her tits, and sticking their hands under her dress. Jenny was moaning loudly and squatting slightly as their fingers penetrated her. I've got two fingers in your wife, in your, I've got two fingers in your wife's cunt, Jim told me.
Oh my.
And one halfway up her ass. Ed chimed in. I looked on in utter fascination as Jenny tried to hump all three fingers, squatting and grunting with a crazed look in her eyes, until she came quickly and loudly, sandwiched between two men. Why don't you sit over there, a grinning Jim said to me, and watch as we fuck your hot wife. She's gonna love this, I said. Jim smiled. Tell your husband what you really are, he said to Jenny. I'm a slut, Jenny said, looking at me half dazed. I want to be a nasty slut, like those bitches in the letters to Penthouse you read. A slut who can't get enough cock. A good and faithful wife who turns into a whore at the drop of a man's trousers. Jim had moved behind her and was squeezing her tits. I've been thinking about this for a while now, Jenny went on, ever since you first mentioned it. Jim was unzipping her, pulling her dress down past her shoulders. I've never been with anyone but you, never wanted anyone but you until you told me about your fantasies. Her bra was now off, and Jim and Ed squeezed her big tits and rolled her thick nipples around until they stood stiff and proud. Jenny looked back at Jim. Don't be gentle with me, she told me, then turned back to me. Do you like what you see? She demanded. Jim was kissing her neck and Ed was sucking a tit as Jenny held his head against her. Oh, God, I can't wait to fuck them right in front of you. Jim pulled her dress down past her belly and over her big, round ass. Since she had taken her panties off in the lounge, Jenny was now naked. Turn around and bend over, Jim ordered. Show us that ass. That's it, girl. Spread your legs. Jenny wiggled her ass slightly. Her thick pussy lips poked out from her untrimmed bush, glistening with her excitement. Jim and Ed stood on either side of her. Ed smearing juice from her pussy onto her asshole.
Oh my gosh.
While Jim began to finger fuck her cunt. First with one thick finger, then two. Jenny was grunting and moaning as Ed began to probe her asshole slowly.
Probe, I love it.
She clearly loved having their fingers inside her. Ed smiled at me. Your wife likes her ass poked, he said, probing more deeply into her anus as she humped back and forth. Jenny was moaning for them to fuck her now, and fuck her hard. The two men stopped fingering her and began to undress. You might as well eat your woman out, buddy, Ed said to me, because after I come inside her, she'll never taste the same again.
Oh.
Ooh.
This one's raunchy, you guys.
Damn.
I went to her and did as he said. Jenny was dripping wet, smelling funky, and tasting great. Oh, eat me, honey, she moaned as I tongued her. Get my pussy ready for their cocks. Eat her ass, because we're going to fuck that too.
What? It said that?
Yeah. Jim told me.
No.
Jenny moaned louder and backed up against my mouth as I stuck my tongue up her behind. That's enough, I heard Ed say after a minute. She's ours now, buddy. Get out of the way. They had both stripped naked, and I began to back away as I saw their erect cocks. Each was about 8 or 9 inches long.
Damn.
And amazingly thick. Now Daniel's perks up. Jim gave my wife a light slap on the ass, telling her to get on the bed, spread her legs. She did so without hesitation, and Jim moved between her legs, grabbing her ankles and spreading her wide. He told me to put a pillow under her head. Look at me when I stick my cock in you, he told her. Grinning at her, he rubbed his tool up and down her dripping slit, making my wife moan and hump up at him in a vain effort to capture his cock. Put it in me, she begged. Fuck me with it. Don't play with me, please. Still grinning, he eased the head of his dick between her engorged pussy lips, then pushed in a little more. Oh, yes. Oh, fuck me, she cried. He pushed on till it was about halfway into her, smiling down as her eyes locked on his, her mouth pleading with him to give her all of his meat. Fuck me. God damn it. Fuck me with your big black dick, she yelled. Finally, he buried himself inside her to the balls. And then he began to fuck her really hard. Oh my God, she cried over and over as he slammed his meat home. His ass muscles flexing as he drove in and out of her. You've got a big pussy, baby, he told her as she squirmed underneath his steady thrust. You sure you've never fucked a brother before? Fuck my big pussy. my big married pussy. Ginny babbed. Fuck me hard. Fuck my slutty cunt all to hell. Jim began to pound her harder and faster, and Ginny clearly loved it. Arching her hips and thrusting back at him, crying out for him to give it to her, she groaned with frustration. But when he pulled his member out of her, but at once Ed took over, fucking her roughly and making her big breast shake violently. Jim reached out to squeeze those breasts, and he got up on his knees and guided his cock into her mouth. She licked and sucked his dick and balls as Ed kept on fucking her at a steady pace. They took turns fucking her cunt and her mouth, switching off for 15 or 20 minutes until Ginny came again. Oh, God, that was great, she panted. I've never felt so full before. I love your big cocks. I need your big cocks. Well, we love your big pussy, Jim said, smiling down at her. Now get on your knees and show your husband how you love to suck my big black dick. My wife slid off the bed and went to her knees in front of them. Then Ginny looked up at me. Just like the nasty little slut in the letters to Penthouse you love so much, Ginny said. Watch me blow them now. I hope you enjoy watching me fuck them fuck my mouth. Jim's cockhead was in front of her mouth, and she opened up and took in as much of him as she could. I was amazed to see her gradually swallow at least half of it, displaying a talent she had never shown with me. She grabbed Jim's muscular ass with her hands and pulled him even further. Oh yeah, baby, suck my big dick for your husband. Ginny looked up at me from time to time as she sucked his dick, eagerly using her mouth on him however he wanted. He particularly liked having the underside of his tool licked and nibbled, and his nuts sucked. His heavy balls got plenty of attention from Ginny, and he really loved it. You're one hell of a cocksucker, lady. He told her.
Lady.
Finally, Ed got impatient and pulled her mouth from Jim's nuts. My turn. Suck my dick now, he demanded, and Ginny eagerly complied, swallowing half of his tool. Oh yeah, suck it. Ed panted As her head bobbed up and down, she reached around and grabbed his ass and pulled much of him into her mouth as she could. Fuck, you're good, Ed told her. She pulled his cock out of her mouth and looked at me, spit covering her mouth and chin. I love having his big dick halfway down my throat, honey. Is that what you want to hear? That your wife loves to suck cock and balls? Suck my nuts again, Jim told her, pulling her head against his crotch. They helped her to her feet, then she came over to me, a mixture of saliva and pre-cum covering her mouth. Her hair was a mess. Oh my God. I smelled the delicious funk coming from her cunt as she leaned over and whispered into my ear. Does this make your little dick hard watching this? She reached down and felt my stiff 5-inch prick. Yes, it sure does, she said. But I doubt that it'll be enough for me after tonight. She kissed me roughly, shoving her tongue in my throat. Your ass is next, girl, Ed responded, shaking his dick at her. How about it? You want this big cock in that married ass? Ginny looked at me again. The faithful wife who lets strange men butt fuck her. Is that what you want me to be? She asked. She didn't wait for an answer, but moved over to a chair and bent over the arm with her ass sticking out and up. Jim and Ed went to her and began to caress her ass cheeks, pulling them apart, showing me her asshole. Jim stuck his finger in her cunt to get it wet, then began to poke at her back door. She looked over her shoulder at me. You want them to fuck my ass? Stick their cocks where that finger is? Damn right, Ginny said. Go on, Ed, stick your dick in there and fuck my virgin ass. Not that way, Ed said. Lie down on your back, girl. Ginny moved around the sofa and laid down. Jim and Ed took one of their legs and pulled them up until she was lying on her back with her ass in the chair. Reach down and spread those cheeks for me, Ed said. Tell me what you want, Ed said. Your dick in my ass, that's what I want, Ginny moaned. Ed crouched over her and slowly began to take my wife's anal cherry. Her eyes were closed, a look of concentration on her face. Relax that ass for me, girl. That's the way, Ed said. He eased his cock a couple of inches inside her. Ginny caught her breath. Relax, baby, and pull your ass apart for me, Ed said. And she did. Oh, it's so big. It's so fucking big. You'll get used to it. You ready for more? Yeah, I'm ready for more. Fuck my fat ass with your fat dick, she moaned as he drove deeper into her. He was almost buried now, and their eyes locked. It's good. I like it. It's so big, she said. He gave her the last of it. Then burying his big cock to the balls inside my moaning wife. Oh, God, yes. Fuck my slutty ass with your big cock. He picked up the pace and she began to thrust back at him, looking up at me, eyes wild, tit shaking. Grand finale, babe, Jim told her as he let go of her legs. And Ed pulled out of the bottom. You ready for some cream filling? I'm ready for anything, Ginny moaned. Jim lay down next to her, his cock standing straight up, and pulled her on top of him. She cried out with passion as she slowly sank onto his huge rod. Jim pulled her down to kiss her, exposing her ass to Ed, who got behind her and once again slid his dick into her rear passage.
Passage.
Then both of them were fucking her. As she screamed out her pleasure to the world at large. After shooting into my wife, the guys got dressed and left. But that night, as I said, changed our lives. In the last few months, Ginny has become a wild woman, fucking me every night, and she can't get enough because she can't. She's now looking for another guy or two to fuck her in our bed. And I hope she finds them soon. Hello, and welcome to the Moo Moo commercials.
Kickstart a fresh fall routine with HelloFresh. HelloFresh handles all the meal planning and shopping to deliver everything you need to cook up a tasty meal right at home. They do the hard part, and you get to take the credit.
HelloFresh takes the stress out of a mealtime, dude. Because listen, sometimes it can be stressful. And when you're thinking, oh, okay, we'll just make sandwiches or something. And you know the kids are going to say, oh, Mom, we had sandwiches yesterday. And you know they're gonna, okay? They deliver fresh ingredients and easy recipes right to your door. You don't even got to leave the house, you guys. This fall, skip that extra trip to the grocery store and have dinner ready in no time with America's number one meal kit. Okay, Paige, you know this. My thing is I love the cooking part. The actual cooking part of cooking I love. What I don't love is the planning. What are we having? You gotta make a list. You gotta think about it. Well, we just had that. Can't have that too close to last time we had it. Gotta go to the grocery store. That's the part that I don't love. And that's why I love HelloFresh, because guess what? I ain't got to think about nothing.
Pre-portioned meals, baby.
Oh, baby. Guess who's not thinking about nothing? Me. Go to HelloFresh.com/viralfree and use code viralfree for free breakfast for life. One breakfast item per box while subscription is active. That's free breakfast for life at HelloFresh.com/viralfree with code viralfree.
Oh, what a great story.
The fact that he said she can't get enough because she can't was really sweet.
I love how towards the end, Daniels got bored and started scrolling on his phone.
Daniels, you can't do that on here.
No, you can't do that on here.
This is a no phone zone.
That was tough.
No phone zone. And that's why I don't read Letters to Penthouse a lot anymore, because a lot of the stories, that's one of the shortest stories there was. They're long.
Wow. Yeah, they are long.
They're long.
Yeah, we already read through all the short ones.
We already did the short ones.
But they give out some good words, you know, probing.
Probing.
Passage. Yeah.
Passage.
Got me.
Passage and tool. Probing. Yeah, what's the tool? Rod. That's the cock.
Anal cherry.
Yeah, that one was a good one. I can't even remember who popped my anal cherry.
Anal cherry. Wow, dude.
Huh?
Anal cherry.
Anal cherry.
Yeah, did you hear that in there? Were you scrolling?
No, I know. I heard it.
Daniels loves scrolling. He has scoliosis more than anybody.
You'll never
in
meet anyone that wants to be on their phone more than Daniels.
Yeah.
Especially at any time. Important time, serious time. Mm-hmm. Don't matter. This motherfucker's going to be scrolling.
I will say you're a close second.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Maybe.
Yeah. Maybe. Yeah.
Okay.
But I don't know. How long are you on your phone today?
Not long, actually, because I've been driving. When we were at dinner or lunch, did I have my phone out?
I don't think so. No, you're right. You didn't. You have gotten
long. That's rare.
Yeah, it's very rare.
I will tell you, when I was going through like all that anxiety and stuff the last couple years, that was like a crutch. Like, that's a way to like keep your mind from racing. Mm-hmm. So that's why I was on it so much.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're right.
Wait, what were you saying? It's a...
A crutch? Like a distraction.
Oh, yeah. Okay. TikTok or what?
Just anything.
Yeah.
It's almost like a comfort blanket.
Sure.
Kind of.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. All right. We got a couple more go ahead, Maggie. A couple more calls. Gary, where'd you come from, Gary?
I'm scratching on my leg.
Oh, Mama's world.
And Tilly was down there playing. It was so cute when you were reading.
The babies are in studio tonight. All right.
Hi, gang. Fuck, marry, kill. Florida, Oregon, and Kansas. Oh, yeah?
Ooh. Fuck, marry, kill. Florida, Oregon, Kansas.
I got it.
Okay. Go.
I'm going to kill Kansas.
Do fuck first. Do it in order.
Okay. Fuck Florida, marry Oregon, kill Kansas.
Ooh. Same.
Same, yeah.
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 And Brett's from Kansas.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, dude.
It's pretty flat out there.
Yeah. I'm going to go same.
Same.
I'd want to marry Oregon because I'd want to be there all the time.
Yes.
I'm killing Oregon.
What?
What about the mushrooms?
Yeah.
I don't care about
that. Have you ever been to Oregon?
Don't want to.
What?
Why not?
Why?
So you've never been there?
It's the greenery.
Why would you not want to? Yeah, why would you not want to go to a place you've never been?
Because I don't have a desire to. I just think of Portland, and I don't. I just
Oregon.
Do you know what Portland? Do you know what Oregon looks like?
No.
Oh, if you did, you'd marry Oregon.
It's beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my
God. So what are you doing then?
Yeah, what are you
Who
doing?
Who are you fucking?
I'm actually marrying Florida.
Okay.
And I'm sleeping with Kansas.
Okay.
And sleeping.
Okay.
We're playing SMK.
Interesting.
Sorry. I was just PG.
Okay. Well, not
I,
on
I,
it.
I know.
I just said I just said anal cherry.
I know.
She just read letters to Penthouse.
And he's worried about PG.
Yeah, I know. He's playing Sleep, Marry, Kill.
I just said. Okay. Interesting. Okay. That's cool.
You got to remember, I don't normally videotape stuff like this.
Yeah, you're right.
That is very true. Hey, but why are you loving? That is very true. Whoa.
Yeah.
That's funny. Mm-hmm. Why are you choosing Florida to marry?
Got to be quicker with your answers.
Damn, I don't have an answer.
Because you don't have to. This isn't really that serious. You can just be like, oh, I've been there once.
I was maybe taking a little too literal, probably.
You don't really have to marry a state.
Oh, yeah. You don't have to go sign papers or anything.
No, you don't have to go to courthouse or nothing. We're just talking here.
Look at Brian.
We're just talking
Look
here.
At Brian.
I was looking at the next question.
Gary. All right,
you're getting your answer ready.
Let's do the next question.
Shit. Oh, wow.
Let's do it, baby.
Yeah, buddy.
Hey, honey. Drunk here.
Oh!
Woo!
Okay. Kill, fuck, marry. Famous edition. Brad edition. Bradley Cooper. Brad Pitt. Brad Paisley. Been on that one.
On the Brad.
Oh, yeah!
Oh, they're having fun.
They are.
Okay, they fuck, are. Marry, kill. That's Bradley cute. Cooper, Brad Pitt, Brad Paisley. Ooh, can I go first?
Yeah.
Fuck Brad Pitt, because come on. Marry Brad Paisley.
Huh?
Kill Bradley Cooper.
I'm shocked. Ooh.
Why would you not want to marry Brad Paisley? Good, wholesome family man. I don't think there's anything attractive about Bradley Cooper, and I've always thought that.
And that's fine.
Huh.
I don't think there's anything attractive about him.
Huh.
Honestly, I saw pictures of him because he's dating Gigi Hadid or whatever the heck right now. And I was looking and I'm like, you know what? He's not anything that special to me. I was zooming in. But
exactly.
Like, he just looks like a normal guy, everyday guy. Nothing sticks out.
So are you...
But I don't know what Brad Paisley really looks like.
Well, Brad Paisley's not like a super attractive guy. He just seems like he would be. He's been married to the same woman for like what, 25 years?
Good, wholesome man.
Seems like he'd be a good husband.
Never had much drama.
No, yeah. No drama. You know.
Sings.
Yeah,
he can sing.
He seems like he'd be a good husband.
Okay.
Even Brad Pitt and Bradley Cooper I don't see them like settling down and being a good husband. But I'm fucking Brad Pitt.
I feel like Brad Pitt fit. When he fucks, he feels stiff. He seems like a stiff guy.
Like his whole body's stiff.
Like, yeah. Like,
not
he'd just
limber.
Be a hard fucker, like, not too groovy. So I'm just going to fuck Bradley Cooper, marry Paisley, and kill Pitt.
Wow.
Damn.
What about you, Daniels?
I got to kill Paisley.
Wow.
And marry Cooper.
And fuck Brad Pitt.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Maggie?
I'm with Daniels on this one.
Look at Gary.
Brad Paisley's got to die.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd kill Paisley, marry Pitt. You know.
You're gonna marry Pitt?
Yeah, just have him for long. He's got that.
I love
got
that.
The most money.
I love that Brett has no clue who Brad Paisley is.
He's a country singer, right?
I just said that.
He's with Peyton Manning commercials.
Sure.
Yeah. No, well, I think that's Luke Bryan.
He sings. Baby, lock them doors and turn them lights down low.
I just saw Luke Bryan with.
Yeah, I did see that.
Oh,
too.
Okay. Yeah. So he's on there too.
Well, what a wonderful evening.
I'm sad that we're done.
Daniels, thank you so much for joining us on our podcast.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for going down the personal journey with me.
Absolutely.
Oh, that was fun.
How do you suck dick?
How do
you suck dick?
We should play that sound bite at least.
Let's play it.
I'm looking for it. I was looking.
Let's play it.
Hold on.
Do you listen to our podcast ever?
I'm not a big podcast listener. I'll watch it more than I listen
How
to it.
How do you suck dick?
One more time.
How do you suck dick?
How do you suck dick?
I want her to call back in. And
I know.
How do you suck dick?
That's all? That was the whole phone call?
That was the whole phone call.
That was literally the phone call.
So we're like, let's make it a sound bite.
Did you teach her?
We talked about it.
We taught her that, yeah.
Yeah, we taught her.
What episode? I'll have to go watch.
All right. Thank you for being here. Thank you guys for helping us take over the world. Please. I do have a rock fucker of the week.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
Sorry,
oh,
Bette.
Shit, shit that ass. Now movement like. Hey.
Sorry, Bette. What's up? Spit it out.
Shit, Maliki.
Caroline White is this week's rock fucker of the week. Caroline White. My phone just died. Maggie will get you a piece of Viral Podcast merch. And guys, please be sure to check out the viralpodcast.co.
And the Viral Podcast Instagram.
Yeah.
And Daniels, what should people call in with?
It's anonymous, right?
Well, yeah.
Just a topic, like what... Because we're going to give them the phone number. Something, so just call in with whatever.
Something they got away with.
Ooh. Call in with something you got away with at 442-777-3331. And always remember that you are doing great.
You're looking good.
And fuck what everybody else thinks.
What the? Shit. Keep it going.
Keep it going. Keep going.
You hate that.
Get in my hole, we're going viral. All right.
That's
that was
wild.
A good time. That was fun.